reality is not the truth, but I really rely on him to make me forget about my reality. Fast forward to August, my ex-boyfriend's parents told him he'd be going to Nigeria for 3 weeks and coming back to America. Well, he got to Nigeria, and his father told him they actually wanted him to stay for a year or longer. I didn't even get to say goodbye to him. The only thing that really made me happy was gone. I was so afraid if I got sick again, my senior would not be around to help keep me going. So that was the second traumatic experience of 2019. This is where I started to fall into a deep depression. During this time, I wanted to do whatever it took to numb the pain. But having parents made it hard to get away with things, so I decided to move into my friend's house in the beginning of December. I started trying to find love from other guys that were treating me horribly. I started smoking marijuana more often and would have horrible trips where my heart would race 165 beats per minute. I didn't care anymore about anything. Even though I was really far gone, my mom has continued praying for me. She was so afraid when I moved out, so she asked the woman in the church group chat to pray for me to come home. I continued going out with my friends all night, hanging out with guys that were treating me terribly, smoking weed and drinking, etc. Basically going down the wrong path very quickly. I was trying to fill a void with things of this world, but the good feelings I got from those things never lasted. Only 2 weeks of moving out, I hit rock bottom. I thought I would just sleep one night at home and then go back to doing my own thing, but that was not the case. The night I came back home, I had a massive panic attack. Nothing could calm me down. I tried listening to meditation music, but that
Witnesses are on the banks of the river just like they would have been on the banks of the Jordan when Jesus was baptized. And we remember that when Jesus was baptized, the sky opened up. So we have the very natural setting here at the Hudson with the clouds and some of the sun peering through. And Jesus was baptized and the Holy Spirit descended like a dove upon him. And Jesus heard the voice of God say, "Well done, my good and faithful servant." So this is another aspect of the baptism today, representing Fiona's death to self, finding her new life in Jesus Christ, and being risen to that new life, just like she shared in her testimony this morning. So everybody on Zoom and everybody here on the banks of the Hudson, you are witnesses of this moment in Fiona's faith journey. She's already accepted Jesus Christ. This is just a symbol of her expression that she's going to follow Jesus the rest of her life. So you are all her family of faith, you are all her supporters, and it gives us a great joy to welcome you. So thanks for coming. I baptize you.